Hello, welcome to my today class. Yeah, now we already discussed in the previous class a few problems based on suppose the given differential equation is a non-homogeneous differential equation. In that case, we discussed in the last class, suppose Q of X is a non-homogeneous means what? Actually, Q of X is not equal to 0. Suppose Q of X is an exponential function, how to find out pi for, so right hand side or Q of X must be equal to exponential function. We discussed, we solved one problem. Now we are going to consider a few more problems in this class. Okay, now the problem, solve the following differential equations. Today is the first problem, but overall this is a second problem. The problem is d square of dt square x of t minus 5 into the derivative of x of t plus 6 into x of t equals e power of t plus 1 whole square. Now observe carefully here, they given x is a dependent variable. X is dependent variable. That's a very, very important. Usually we are taking what? Dependent variable is y. But here they given dependent variables y is dependent on which variable? T. Therefore, t is independent variable. Yeah. First, you observe carefully in the problem and then you proceed. Suppose it's not given y, you can't take y. Suppose you write it y, definitely you are going to lose the marks. Okay. Now, as usual, now here first I have to convert the given differential equation in terms of differential operator d square of x of t. X of t means x is function of t, that's all. Minus 5 into first derivative of x of t plus 6 into x of t. Then I have to expand this for our convenience, just like a plus b whole square, a square, e power of t whole square. E power of t whole square is nothing but e power of t into e power of t. Bases of same, add up the indices, we get e power of 2t plus 2ab. 2ab, a is e power of t, b is 1 plus b square is 1. Okay. And what's the next step? I have to keep y outside like that, x of t outside, d square minus 5d plus 6 into x of t equals e power of 2t plus t, 2 into e power of t plus 1. Okay. Now, we already known that this is nothing but f of d. This is what actually f of d. Now, you know that how to write the auxiliary equation. What's the auxiliary equation is? Replace d by m and then equal to 0. Means what we get actually m square minus 5m plus 6 is equal to 0. Is it the given then f of d, once you write the auxiliary equation, we get a polynomial degree 2. You know how to evaluate, either you have to factorize or you go for quadratic formula. How can, now in this case, what's the value of a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 5, and c is equal to 6. Is already explained in the last class. A into c is nothing but 6. Once you take two numbers, multiplication of two numbers, that product must be what you are expecting, 6. Add and subtract what you are expecting, minus 5. Therefore, what we are going to take? 3 into 2. No, you can't take 6 into 1. Suppose I have to take 6 into 1, the minus 6 plus 1. Once you add, we get minus 5, but you multiply, we get minus 6. What we are expecting? 6. Therefore, what are the two factors? Are nothing but 3 and 2. Therefore, this is minus 3, this is minus 2. Now, what we get? Minus 3 and minus 2 are, then once you multiply that, minus into minus plus 6, and then add, we get minus 5. It satisfies both the things. Once you multiply, we get AC. Add, we get minus 5 for b value. Therefore, now this can also be written as m square minus 3m minus 2m plus 6 equal to 0. Group first to take common factor. What's a common factor? M is a common, m minus 3. No, I told in the previous class and also while solving a homogeneous differential equation also, what's the factor you have here, m minus a. Once you group these two, we are expecting the common factor, the factor is m minus a. That's why what we are going to take, only the common factor from these two terms is 2. But we are going to take minus sign also outside. Why? Because already in the first term, we have a factor m minus a. Suppose you convert in the second term also m minus a, then easy to take common factor. Therefore, m minus a equal to 0. From these two terms, what's the common factor? M minus 3 into m minus 2 equal to 0. That implies, now we get the roots. Both the roots are real and distinct. You know how to write a CA for this using case A. We discussed in the first class, complementary functions are nothing but c1 into e power of 3 into what's the independent variable is t. You can't write x here. Yeah. Plus, either you write this one or this, both does not matter. c2 into e power of 2t. Okay. This is a complementary function. But I want to find out what actually pi. Finding a PI, they have three terms, 1, 2, 3. Better to take PI 1, PI 2 and PI 3. Then I to avoid the mistake. Okay. Now, in the next step, first I have to find out PI 1. Now, PI 1 is nothing but, you know that what's the formula for finding PI? The reciprocal of f of d into q of x. What is first term of the q of x is? E power of 2t. What is my f of d is nothing but 1 by d square minus 5d plus 6 into e power of 2t. I told a number of times in the previous class, whenever you want to find out pi for exponential function, one point I have to observe carefully. What's a value here? A is equal to 2. Observe whether 2 is a root of the auxiliary equation. Yes, 2 is one of the root of the auxiliary equation. How many roots? Only one root. See, therefore, you can't go for 1 by f of a into e power of at. That's a formula. Suppose a is not a root of the auxiliary equation. But here, a is equal to 2 is a root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, how is a one root or a double root? Is a one root. What's the formula? What's the formula for finding pi is? Now I have to add t, don't add x because independent variable is t into f dash of, this is nothing but actually f dash of d of e power of 2t. Okay, t divided by what is f dash of d? 2d minus 5 e power of 2t. Then what we are going to replace? Replace d by a. What is my a is 2. Therefore, what we get? 4 minus 5 into e power of 2t. Now, what is that value? Is nothing but minus t into e power of 2t because 4 minus 5 is minus 1. Don't confuse. I am going to explain once again. Here, if we want to write, since 2 is the one of the root of the auxiliary equation. Okay. That's why the formula is what actually t divided by f dash of d into e power of 2t. That's why first you find out derivative and then replace d by a. A is what? 2. Then we get, definitely don't get it 0. Here you replace d by a 2, definitely we get minus 10 plus 10 is cancelled. Because it's one of the root. One of the root means this expression must be equal to you. This equation must be 0. Then we say that that's one of the root of the corresponding polynomial. Now, this is a way I have to find out exponential function. Suppose there is the e power of at, a is a root of the given auxiliary equation. The next, I have to move to the second one, pi2. If pi2 is nothing but 1 by f of d. What is f of d? D square minus 5d plus 6 into e power of d. Better I have to keep 2 outside, that does not matter because it's a what is that actually? Constant. Now observe carefully, what is the a value here? 1. 1 is not a root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, what's the, how to proceed for pi? Replace d by a. Means 1 square minus 5 into 1 plus 6 into e power of t. 2 divided by, yeah. What we get actually? No, we get 2. Observe, this is a, one of the thing. Observe carefully and then I to proceed. Now 1 minus 5 plus 6, we get 1, we get 2 into e power of t. What's the remaining here? E power of t. The next, move to the next one. What's the my next one here actually? Next one is nothing but p by 3 is nothing but 1 by d square minus 5d plus 6 into what actually? Constant 1. But we see, I'm not explaining in the last class how to find out pi for constant. Now, this one can also be written as, you already known that, one can also be written as e power of 0. Therefore, one can also be written as 0 into t. What's the independent variable? T. Therefore, first you have to express, whenever having a constant, first you have to express in terms of exponential. How to express? E power of 0 into t, t is an independent variable. Now, 0, what is my a value? A is equal to 0. 0 is not a root of the auxiliary equation. What is my pi? Is 1 by replace 0, my 5 into 0 plus 6 into 1. And then e power of 0 into t. And then this is nothing but actually 1 by 6 pi 3 is nothing but 1 by 6. In the next step, now this is a way I to find out the value of pi for the constant function. The next step is, what is my pi? Pi is nothing but pi is nothing but pi 1 plus pi 2 plus pi 3. What is my pi 1? Is nothing but minus t into e power of 2t, and then pi 2 is e power of t, and then this is nothing but 1 by 6. This is nothing but particular integral of the given differential equation. Okay. Next is general solution. General solution is y equals cf plus pi. What is cf? Cf is nothing but c1 into e power of 3t plus c2 into e power of 2t minus t into e power of 2t plus e power of t plus 1 by 6. This way I to find out the solution of the, not y, again I did mistake here, because here what they given dependent variable is x, x is function of t. Or just you write x. It's a way I to solve. Solve means find the value of dependent variable in terms of independent variable. I may be a independent variable, I may be having constant. See, one of the term having constant is the required general solution. Why you treated this as a general solution, still having involving unknown, is not given any boundary conditions in this problem. I think in this problem is clear how to find out pi value for the exponential function. Suppose e power of at, a is a one of the root of the auxiliary equation, how to proceed? Now, this is a way I to do it. Now, I'm showing two slot. Now, in the first step, you know how to find out CF. You are familiar with that. After that, I'm going to find out pi for term by term. But the first term, a is 2. The 2 is a one of the root of the auxiliary equation. What's the formula? T divided by f dash of t into e power of at, and then replace d by a. Then suppose it's a double root, means t square divided by f double dash of t. Similarly, I have to take second term, but a is equal to 1 is not a root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, what's the formula? 1 by f of a into e power of at. The last term is constant. How to find out pi for the last constant is, first you have to express in terms of the exponential. After once you express in terms of exponential, observe what is a is 0. 0 is not a root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, what's the formula? 1 by f of a into e power of a. Then you take that sum that gives rise to particular integral. Sum of CF and PI is nothing but general solution of the corresponding given differential equation. Yeah. Now I'm showing the entire problem in two slots. Yeah, this is the first slot, and then I move to this part. Okay. Next, we move to the next different type of problem. Today's second problem, solve y double dash minus 2y dash plus y equals 3 into e power of x, given that y is equal to 1 at x is equal to 0 and y dash is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0. It is very clear y double dash and y dash is nothing but derivative, first, second derivative and first derivative of y with respect to x. Why? Because observe carefully in q of x. Now, in the q of x, what's a variable involved here? X. Keep in mind, always q of x may be a constant r. Function of independent variable. Okay. Therefore, from this is very clear y is function of x. The first step is solution. What's the given actually? Given is nothing but y double dash minus 2y dash plus y equal to 3 into e power of x. Now observe carefully what is y dash is derivative of y with respect to x. Similarly, y dash is nothing, y double dash is second derivative of y with respect to x. Okay, fine. Now, first try to express in terms of the differential operator. Therefore, d square y minus 2dy plus y equal to 3 into e power of x, where what is d stands for derivative with respect to x. This can also be written as d square minus 2d plus 1 into y equals 3 into e power of x. What's the next step? This is nothing but actually f of d. What's our next step? To write the auxiliary equation, how we get auxiliary equation? Replace d by m and then equal to 0. So what we get actually? M square minus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0. This is just a k square minus 2ab plus b square. What is that? M minus 1 whole square. M minus 1 whole square, because 2m term is negative, only the possibility a minus b whole square. Expand m minus 1 whole square. M square minus 2m plus 1 only. Now here we get two repeated real roots we get. M minus 1 equal to 0, m minus 1 equal to 0. That implies m is equal to 1 and also m is equal to 1. Now, totally how many roots are expecting? Two roots, because it's a polynomial degree 2. Therefore, what is my CF? CF is nothing but it's repeated real roots. How many times are repeated? Two times. So C1 plus C2x. Yeah, independent variables x into e power of x. M1 is equal to M2. Therefore, this is my CF. Next, I have to find out PI. Yeah. Pi is only one term, it's not necessary to take term by term, divide is nothing but 1 by f of d. What is f of d? D square minus 2d plus 1 into 3. 3 is a constant, keep it outside, e power of x. What's the value of a here? Here a is equal to 1. But 1 is a double root. You already know that 1 is a double root of the given differential equation. Now we have to write here a is equal to 1, this is double root of auxiliary equation. Is a double root, so double root of auxiliary equation. Therefore, what's the formula here? I have to differentiate how many times? Two times. Now, the formula for this is nothing but 3 into, I have to add x square in the numerator, x square because independent variable is x, divided by f double dash of d into e power of x. Differentiate how many times? Two times. What's the first derivative of this? F of d is what actually? D square minus 2d plus 1. What is f dash of d? It's nothing but 2d minus 2. What is f double dash of d? Is 2. Because derivative of constant is 0. Just like a finding a derivative of x square. What is derivative of x square? 2 is like that 2d. And then minus 2 into 1, 0. Again, I have to differentiate derivative of d is 1, we get to constant is 0. That's all. What we are doing, know that differentiation, same thing, instead of x, we have d, that's all. By 2, f double dash of d is 2 into e power of x. What actually, next step, what's the, it's a double root means, what's the formula? X squared divided by f double dash of d. For d is equal to a, e power of ax is a formula. But not necessary to replace d by a. Because there is no afternoon, so differentiate twice, we get a constant. This itself is a what particular solution. Don't confuse. First, you have to differentiate two times with respect to d and then replace d by a. This is a formula, suppose it's a double root. Now, but in this problem, what happened? Once you find out second derivative, we get a constant. Therefore, not necessary to replace d by a. Therefore, now what is my general solution? General solution is y equals cf plus pi. What is my cf? It's nothing but c1 plus c2x into e power of x. And then plus 3x square by 2 into e power of x. Now, observe, now here, this is our general solution, but they're given some boundary condition. They're given x, y is equal to 1 for x is equal to 0, and also y dash is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0. Now, they're given two boundary conditions. Then I to use, with the help of two boundary conditions, try to find out c1, c2. That gives us particular solution. We already done that type of thing where in the homogeneous differential equation. Whenever they provide boundary condition, I have to proceed further. In the first step, now what we are going to do here, put, because they are given y value, y is equal to 1, and x is equal to 0. Put x is equal to 0 in star. Once you put x is equal to 0, y is nothing but y of 0. Means y at x is equal to 0. You have to write y of 0 or you have to write y for x is equal to 0. Then c1, but c2 is 0. Why? Because c2 into 0. X is 0. E power of 0. What is e power of 0? You know that. 3 by 2 into 0 into e power of 0. Okay. This implies y at x is equal to 0 is 1 equal to c1. E power of 0 is 1. This is 0. Okay. This is 0. And also this is also must be 0. Only we get c1 is equal to 1. For first boundary condition, we get one of the unknown value for one of the constant value c1 is equal to 1. Next, I have to take the value of y dash. If you want to take y dash, I have to differentiate once on both sides with respect to x. Differentiate. Star. With respect to x, what we get? Dy by dx or y dash, whatever may be. It's nothing but, while doing differentiation, go for product rule. Derivative of first function, 0, c2 into, what is derivative of x with respect to x is 1, into second function. First function into derivative of the second function, what is derivative of second, e power of x. Again, come to the second term, you go for product rule. What is derivative of x square? 2x into second function plus x square into derivative of e power of x is e power of x. You already know that derivative of e power of ax is what? E power of ax into a. What is a? Is 1. That's all. Okay. In the next step, we put x is equal to 0. Put x is equal to 0. In double star, that implies y dash bar x is 0. Yeah. Here c2 into e power of 0. What is e power of 0? Is 1. Plus c1 you have c1. Okay. Yeah. You have c1, but c2 is 0 because x is 0. c1 into e power of 0 is 1. And then observe carefully, 3 by 2 into entire this flower bracket must be 0. Both terms are multiplied by x. X is 0, then this is must be 0. This implies what is y dash bar x is equal to 0 is 0. They're given 0 is equal to c2 plus c1. But you already know that what's the value of c1? C2 is nothing but minus c1. What is c1 value? 1. Therefore, c2 is minus 1. Okay. In the next step, I have to substitute these two values in the general solution. Once you substitute these two values, that is the required particular solution. Therefore, y equals, what is my y? Y equals c1 is 1, minus c2 is minus 1, x, e power of x, plus 3 by 2 x square e power of x is the required particular solution. It's the required particular solution. Yeah. This is a way I can find out the solution of the given problem. Now this is one of the important problem. In this problem, in explain both the things. What are the things we I explained? I explained the thing is actually in this problem I explained how to find out pi for is a value is a double root of auxiliary equation. How to find out pi using the formula for e power of x, especially for a particular integral. I'm not taking much important for CF because that's also very important, but you already know that, therefore I'm going to leave that part. First, you convert as usual in terms of differential operator and write it auxiliary equation, find out the roots, we get two repeated real roots, and then write from the case 2, B, case B, then write what is CF. And then you write, find out pi. While finding pi, a is equal to 1. A is equal to 1 is a double root of the auxiliary equation. Therefore, what's the formula? X squared divided by f double dash of d for d is equal to a. Then first you differentiate twice. In that case itself, f double dash of d, we get constant x squared by 2 into e power of x. Therefore, now y is equal to cf plus pi. It's nothing but is the general solution of the given problem. But in this problem, they given boundary conditions, they given two boundary conditions, from that we get two these two unknown values. Now put x is 0 in the star, we get c1. If you want to take y dash value, then we have to find out, first find out the derivative with respect to x, and then put x is equal to 0. First you find out derivative value, and then put x is equal to 0, find out then I have to substitute y dash bar x is equal to 0. Keep in mind, if you want to substitute derivative y dash or dy by dx value in the boundary condition, you take a general solution, differentiate once, and then put x is equal to 0. We get is the required particular. Once you substitute the values of c1, see, once you put y dash for x is equal to 0, we get another unknown value. Substitute these two values in the general solution. That is called particular solution. Why we treat it as a particular solution? Because class, based on some constraint, based on boundary condition, we find out the values of C1, C2. What we get, the solution is nothing but particular solution, that is not a general solution. The beauty of the differential equation I told in my first class. Now, why, even though you have a Laplace transform, why you need to go for differential equation means, it's not, whenever you do, once you convert in your core subject statement problem in the form of differential equation, even though we don't have any boundary conditions, you know, easy to solve, easy to find out the solution, but in Laplace, it's not possible without you having a boundary condition. But here, in the differential equation, it's possible to find a general solution and also particular solution. Laplace transform only gives a particular solution. But this method is give both general and particular solution. I think you are clear for this part. Now I'd like to share my notes for the in the further in the e-content in e-section. I solved all different type of problems here, and then you please go through that. I covered some 15-20 years question paper for diploma students. You refer that. In case any problem, definitely at the end of this chapter, I'll share my email ID. You're free to ask the question. Okay. Now, before I'm going to wind up the class, I'm showing this entire problem in two charts. Yeah, this is a first step for finding CF. Next is finding PI. And then write the after once you get a general general solution, then I have to find out a particular solution with the help of boundary conditions. Please go through problem carefully, and then you have to write the answer carefully what they expect in the problem. Okay, thank you very much. Bye, see you, and take care. Please go through all the problems. Come back in the next class. I'm going to discuss the next type of function is suppose Q of X having trigonometry function, not all the trigonometry functions, only sine and cos function. Okay, bye, see you, and take care.